Now then, today, in the box, I've got the Ticktime Desk Timer Cube. Now let's give it a try, but first, be sure to read my full review below and to press like and subscribe. Now many thanks, and let's get on with it. Let's have a look now and see what's inside the box. And here's the Ticktime itself, which looks really good. You'd swear it was made from aluminium, but no, it's made from plastic. But you wouldn't know it to look at it. On the side, you can see all the preset time periods. Although you can define your own, any timer up to 99 hours. There are two buttons on the back, and the USB power input, and there's also the LCD timer display. There's a charging cable, and the only other thing in the box is the excellent user guide. Charging is nice and simple, not USB-C unfortunately, but no matter. And there's the charging status display on the end. I'll press either button to power it on, and then press both together to switch off. To operate it from a preset, just switch on and then set it on its side with the desired preset period facing upwards. You can also manually program it to any time up to 99 hours. And to switch off or to pause, just set it upright again, like that. Now then, this simple and well-made little device could not be easier to use. To set a timer, simply turn the cube onto its side, and to turn off or pause, turn it back to upright. There are six presets inscribed along the sides, and it can be programmed to any time you want, up to 99 hours. There are customizable audio and visual alerts, and a color LCD countdown screen. It's heavy enough to serve as a paperweight, and it's also magnetic, so it can be stuck to your fridge door. At $38.99 is not inexpensive, but the build quality is first rate, and it looks and feels like a premium piece of kit. So if you need a stylish, well-made and easy to use desktop or kitchen timer, and are happy to pay a bit more for quality, then this could be just for you.